I could have died when I was 37 years old as the direct result of long-term exposure to air pollution. I was diagnosed with an aggressive grade 3 bladder cancer. After radical surgery and ongoing treatment, I'm lucky to have survived. I never smoked or worked in an industry with harmful chemicals. I was shocked when my urologist told me that in my case, air pollution was the number one trigger for causing my cancer. I live within 100 meters from one of the proposed unfiltered exhaust stacks and tunnel portals on Victoria Road. Within a kilometer, there will be 3 more unfiltered stacks, and not much further away, another stack at Haverfield. There's no doubt that the pollution spewing from these stacks and from the exhaust pipes of vehicles stuck in the bottlenecks at Iron Cove Bridge and Anzac Bridge will blanket all of Rozell and all the neighboring suburbs. The thousands of users of the Bay Run and Callan Park will also be exposed to these pollutants. The WestConnex website leads you to believe that the pollution will have no risk to health of the people living in these areas. This is blatantly false. The EIS specifically states there would be an increase in concentrations of pollutants where I currently live as a result of the general increase of traffic. This will greatly increase the risk of my bladder cancer recurring. But this won't just affect me. A dive site the size of a mine is proposed directly across the road from Rozell Primary School. Thousands of truck movements will be releasing diesel exhaust fumes for 8 years, together with a century's worth of toxic dust, as well as lethal plumes of emissions meandering from the smokestack up the hill towards the school. A 3-year-old child starting at Rozell Preschool will be subjected to carcinogenic particulate matter for the next 8 years of their school life. What disease will those children be diagnosed with by the time they are 37 years old? It was 20 years ago when my doctor told me about the carcinogenic effect that pollution had on my body. In 2012, the World Health Organization confirmed this by classifying diesel as a carcinogen. By 2013, they declared air pollution a leading cause of death in humans. Our Premier, Gladys Berejiklian, stated recently in the media, "For me personally and for the government, livability, enjoying your local area, enjoying your home is increasingly important." Well, this comment angers me, knowing that WestConnex is systematically wiping out, suburb by suburb, any chance of livability, any chance of enjoying the sanctuary of our homes, and any chance at living a long and healthy life. Where is our government's duty of care? Yeah. I'd like to conclude by reading a final quote. "Members of Parliament should examine their conscience and consider how they would feel if their children or the children of loved ones were exposed to this level of fumes every day, and they were part of a government that could have put in place measures to reduce the impact of the fumes." This was said by Gladys Berejiklian in 2008. Thank you.